A point is 35 mm below HP, 15 mm behind VP, and 25 mm in front or behind or from RPP. Draw its projections and name the side view. So since the condition given is below HP and behind VP, so obviously this point in space is in third quadrant, that is 0 to 180 and 0 to 270. So 180 to 270 will going to be in the third quadrant. So when you look from the front view, we can see the distance below HP. So the below HP distance, which can be seen, which is 35 mm below HP. So that distance can be seen in the vertical plane, which is here. And since the image is on the vertical plane, so it will be the front view, which is P dash. Now 15 mm behind VP. So when you look from the top view, we can see the distance behind VP. So this distance, when you look from the top view, the image will going to fall on the horizontal plane. So since the image is on horizontal plane, it will be small p. So that distance is 15 mm behind VP. Now the condition is 25 mm in front or behind or from RPP. Since it is behind VP, so obviously it should be behind RPP. So how to get this behind RPP? Now we're going to analyze this. This is the condition of the observer. So it has to satisfy the condition of the observer. So when you look from the front view, the object is the plane is between the object and the observer. Observer is the front view. Similarly, when you look from the top view, the plane is between the object and the observer. When you look from the left side view, so the left side view and the right side view, both the views are perpendicular to the right profile plane. So obviously we can see you can see from left side view, or you can also see from the right side view. But when you see from the left side view or the right side view, the image will going to fall here only. That means that is below HP, behind VP. So below HP and behind VP will be seen whether you look from left side or it can be from the right side. Now we have to find the condition whether it is behind RPP or in front of RPP. Now when this is for the condition of the observer. So when you look from the left side view, object is between the plane and the observer. When you look from the right side view, plane is between the object and the observer. So always the condition of the front view has to be satisfied. That means when the plane is between, when you look from the front view, the plane is between the object and the observer. So this condition has to be satisfied. This condition will be satisfied only when you look from the right side view, wherein the plane is between the object and the observer. So the image what you are going to get is here. So when you look from the right side view, it will be behind RPP. So here it is behind VP. So obviously it should be behind RPP in third quadrant. So in third quadrant, the right profile on the image what you get in the right profile plane is always the right side view. So when you look from the right side view, we can see the distance below HP and also behind VP both. So that is, you can see the front view distance and also you can see the top view distance. The front view distance can be seen here and the top view distance can be seen here. Now this is how we will be able to, and when you look from the front view, we can see the distance behind RPP, that is 25 mm behind RPP is seen in the front view, and also when you look from the top view, the 25 mm behind RPP, so that distance can be seen here in the horizontal plane. Now we are cutting it here and then rotating HP by 90 degrees to the top, and also right profile plane is also rotated by 90 degree in the clockwise direction. So HP will be above VP and RPP will be adjacent to VP, so that we can see here that will be in this position. Now correspondingly, all the images with respect to those planes will going to be rotated. So that means when you here, when the distance below HP, that is 35 mm below HP, is seen in the vertical plane, you can see that vertical plane VP, it is 35 mm, and 15 mm behind VP can be seen in the HP. So HP is above XY line, so above the vertical plane, so the top view will be above XY line. The distance with respect to the profile plane, that is 25 mm or in front or behind or from RPP, can be seen in both VP and HP. So that distance will going to be here 25 mm from here and also 25 mm from here. So then when you look from the right side view, where both p dash and p double dash will be on the same line. So p dash and p double dash in the same line, and we can see the distance below HP, which is vertical here. So that is also vertical here. Even in the side view also it is vertical. But when you look from the side view, this distance of behind VP will going to become horizontal when it is rotated in the profile plane. So that distance is this. So here behind VP is vertical here. So that distance has to become horizontal in the profile view. So you project from here to this and then draw a 45 degree line there, where the vertical distance will going to transfer into horizontal distance, and where you have the front view, on that line you are going to get the side view. So there you are going to get P double dash. Since it is behind RPP, so obviously this is going to be the right side view. So now this is how we will be able to get the three-dimensional sketch which has been analyzed. Now we will going to write the final solution. So to do that, in the sketchbook, first we will going to draw the XY line and X1, Y1 line with the thin lines. Mark XY and X1, Y1 and write horizontal plane which is above XY line, vertical plane which is below XY line, and RPP adjacent to vertical plane with the below XY line, because VP is below XY line. So the distance with respect to the profile plane, that is behind RPP, can be seen in both VP and HP. So from X1, Y1 line, you measure 25 mm and also in the vertical plane and also in the horizontal plane, and draw a vertical projector with a thin line, and the distance with respect to VP, that is 35 mm below HP, can be seen in the vertical plane. So you can see, and you mark this point, measure the distance and mark the point as P dash. Then distance behind VP can be seen in HP. So you from XY line, you measure 15 mm above XY line and you mark the point P, and then draw a horizontal projector from the front view to the side view, which is P dash with a thin line, and then draw a 45 degree line adjacent to HP, and then draw a projector from the top view to the 45 degree line, where you are transferring the distance of behind VP, which is 15 mm in vertical direction, has been transferred into horizontal direction, and then draw a vertical projector from that point of the 45 degree line to the profile view, and where the front view and also the top view projected point will going to intersect, that point will going to become P double dash, and then name that point as right side view. So give the directions of projections and give the dimensions. So in the profile view, we can see the distance below HP, and also we can see the distance behind VP. So this is how we will be able to write the final solution in the sketchbook.